Thanks for joining us, guys. Here we have Sergio and Steve from Health Gorilla, and we're going to do a quick interview about our new partnership with DrChrono. I'm Richard, I'm part of the marketing team, and Sergio here. He has come from two really large powerhouses here in the Bay Area for medical groups, both Affinity and University. How do you like working for Health Gorilla?
It's an exciting, thank you for having us, first and foremost. It's a pretty exciting time. We are doing something pretty innovative out there that is very much needed, working with the right partnerships and creating a platform to really drive interoperability across the much needed healthcare landscape.
Great, great. And here we have Steve, the CEO and founder of Health Gorilla. Looks like you have a huge background in health tech as well as data. Looks like you had been working at Pfizer in the past and started Qplex. Raised $1.5 million in funding and had a huge run with it. What's the next big thing?
I think combining my big data qualitative analysis, and my background is in theoretical physics actually, before that, with the exposure to large pharmaceutical companies, I've been there for a few years, with the primary care physicians, and we understand what it's like to be in the front row of the battle that's going on right now, primary care doctors, and what it's like to fight that war in the trenches, and combining that knowledge of the workflows this guy's experience on an everyday basis with qualitative analysis, with security, privacy, data compliance that is prevalent in healthcare. So I think the next big thing for us is creating interoperability, reaching out directly to the primary care doctors, specialists, directly and through partners like DrChrono. Really excited to be here.
Great. Well, thank you guys for joining us today. Sure. And I guess we're going to start off with a really, really easy question. What is Health Gorilla?
Sure. I'll tackle that. Health Gorilla is a clinical network. We are a few years old, a little over 2 years now. We started with connecting independent physicians out there in the country to the entire ecosystem that they communicate on a daily basis. Majority of the doctors in this country already adopted some sort of electronic medical records systems,
right?
Like DrChrono, and there's no secret there are a few others, actually a few hundred of other systems out there. And we're kind of getting into the next evolution of software eating the world, so to speak. And software is eating healthcare in a way that we almost got rid of paper processing within the office, within the hospitals, within diagnostic labs. But there's still huge amount of faxes and paper-based communications going on between physicians, between physicians and the patients, and diagnostic labs, radiology, imaging centers, hospitals, sleep centers, physical therapy. This whole ecosystem communicates by fax a lot of times. So we created something that is viral. It's also extremely easy to use. It's on a mobile device. It's on the web. It's embedded into leading electronic medical records systems like DrChrono. And it provides connectivity, interoperability, as we call it, between physicians, patients, and their ecosystems. So doctors could log into DrChrono, for example, find out who can do certain tests, medical procedure, find that vendor based on insurance for the actual patient, based on proximity, based on the availability of test, quality, turnaround time. We track a lot of things like that, and place electronic order to that facility, receive electronic result or fax, which we'll then digitize and present it to the doctor within the EMR environment or within our mobile app or as a standalone system. Of course, we like working with our EMR partners to create that bridge. The system today is growing pretty fast. It's growing virally. When doctors make referrals to each other, they send entire chart, and that creates that ubiquitous interoperability that we're all after. And I think that's the next evolution in healthcare.
Almost definitely. Yeah. Interoperability, that's the word that we constantly come back to, right?
Kind of a mouthful, but that's what it is today. It's the next big thing,
So what's the story behind Health Gorilla? How did you guys get started? What was the genesis of the idea?
Yeah, just like quite a few successful companies in Silicon Valley, it started with a personal experience. And actually, my wife is a physician. She's a primary care doctor, and, you know, Cuplex was a good, interesting experience for me. It was a great company, and, you know, when we transitioned to something new, I was talking with my wife, and she invited me to her clinics. I went and looked how doctors use computers on a daily basis, and then I saw the fax machine sitting in the back room and spitting out thousands of faxes. And we started digging a little bit. She asked me to help her get rid of that paper, incoming paper. And we discovered that she is on EMR, her service providers are all on the EMR, different EMRs. And because they don't really talk to each other, she places a lot of orders on paper. She does diagnostic testing on paper. Results come back. Very few would come to her EMR, the rest of them.
Wow.
Go on fax and paper, and that was a big problem. And we created the first program, and she was the first user. And before we knew, the system spread to hundreds and now thousands of physicians. We have hospitals, health systems joining us. We have
that's amazing.
Close to 9,000 labs and imaging centers in the country, exchanging data electronically or by fax. But again, it gets digitized and. We see the ratio of fax versus electronic data is shifting towards electronic and getting rid of paper and error-prone processes associated with paper. So that's our goal. That's the story.
Well, that's a great story. It sounds really Silicon Valley-esque.
Yes. Disruption is the name of the game. Yeah.
So what's the next move for you guys for Health Gorilla? What are you guys going to try and tackle in terms of new markets and whatnot?
Yeah. We've been pretty successful in approaching the market and disrupting the market without disrupting any clinical workflows. We're really careful about automating the workflows for doctors, but not really disrupting anything except the paper and fax machine. If you've seen that, one of my favorite movies is Office Space.
Yeah.
That scene when they take the printer out in the field. We do that on a daily basis here. It's like a ritual. But I think... the next big thing for us is continue to work with our partners, like DrChrono. Not all EMRs are ready. We go after, we partner rather with EMRs, electronic medical record providers that are more advanced, that understand where the healthcare is going, like DrChrono. Provide API, robust, secure APIs for us to work with. And I think our focus, specialists and surgeon joined us, has been on going after the accountable care organizations. We strongly believe the next wave in healthcare is going away from fee-for-service to accountable care or shared risk or full risk. And a lot of hospitals today in the country already embarking on that. And Health Gorilla was designed and built specifically to help individual doctors, health organizations, health systems, to adopt to the ACO, accountable care model, shared risk model. And we're just getting started. I think the industry is still trying to finalize what it's going to look like for the next 5 years. But today, I think the trend is already established from the government, from ONC, from individual providers. Everybody's going on that route, and we are kind of in a perfect crossroads position to be able to tackle that problem and grow with the industry.
No, I agree. I mean, what's one of the great things about Health Gorilla is that it's sophisticated simplicity, because the crux of our
system is
that we basically provide a fairly sophisticated tool that can agnostically be applicated across any physician regardless of whatever platform they use. And that's something that should be overlooked, because the reality is that our system, while enhanced with partnerships like DrChrono, can be used across an entire book of business. So it isn't, so today you find that pretty much everybody has a portal. Every vendor has some widget, and doctors and practices and or offices oftentimes find themselves going and navigating through, you know, several tens, if not hundreds of portals on a daily basis. Via a partnership like ours, basically, we can provide a single user experience through which the entire book of business can be satisfied. And as Steve mentioned, given the appetite for true accountability, definitely stemming from, you know, the CMS legislator that's coming down, we are seeing a shift and an evolution in both physicians, offices, and systems sort of aggregating and grouping themselves towards taking a more accountable risk. And in a landscape where you have well over 700 EMR vendors or, you know, systems of care in some shape or form fashion, a system like ours can be, you know, a unique glue to an otherwise, you know, fairly fragmented healthcare landscape.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And really, with all these physicians, the expectation of technology is really so much higher than it was before.
Correct. Especially with the younger generation of doctors.
Absolutely.
That are coming on board. Wouldn't need to explain to them what the iPhone is and how to use mobile devices. And with older generation, it sometimes can be a challenge, but as long as you embrace their existing workflows, they used to fax, so you can't get rid of it day one. You have to go about it eventually. But we have doctors, we have one doctor, I think, who's 92 years old still practicing. Active
wow.
physician. Believe
92.
It or not. Yeah, and he's not an iPhone, but his staff is. So we got him in. But the younger generation, of course, is a lot easier to go through the transition.
So we were talking a little bit about that partnership that you guys have with DrChrono.
Yeah.
Why did you guys choose to go with DrChrono of all EMR systems first?
Absolutely. First of all, we're right next to you. So that's not the main reason.
It was easy to drive over.
Yeah, it's a drive over. But I think... the reality is we looked at many systems of record like EHRs, EMRs, and I think the main reason was we had a lot of overlapping mutual doctors on DrChrono and Health Gorilla, and it was a no-brainer basically for us to start talking, create a partnership for the mutual benefit of partners and definitely to better address the needs of our customers. To do that, there's quite a few companies where we have a lot of doctors, but they are not as advanced as DrChrono was when it comes to sharing and exchanging of records. And the API that you guys built was on par with what we had built, so we could exchange the data. In fact, since we started working with DrChrono, we did the whole integration in a matter of several weeks,
wow.
which is an amazing fit. Which speaks volumes about us making the right decision and partnering with you and you guys having the right platform for us to create interoperability, put thousands of labs, imaging centers in front of DrChrono doctors in a matter of weeks. And we're really excited about the partnership.
It's been an amazing partnership. I mean, the whole staff at, you know, DrChrono, definitely, yeah, especially Tamor, with whom I speak most often. It's been a pleasure to work with, and I think from my view perspective, I think we have a very well-aligned idiosyncrasy in that we are both companies understand where the healthcare landscape is going, and it's going through a pretty clear mandate from CMS in terms of we are moving towards, you know, total accountability and, you know, true risk. So the ability to provide solutions and tools for physicians to really be able to accomplish, you know, true interoperability are paramount. So pretty excited about it.
Great. Well, that pretty much covers Health Gorilla in a small nutshell. Hopefully our viewers can visit you at your website and online.
Or sign up through DrChrono.
Or sign up through DrChrono as well.
Yeah. Sign on. Yeah, that's why we did it.
Yeah. Well, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.
Thank you, viewers, and we'll see you guys next time.
Absolutely.
Take care.